to show you the commissioning, how easy the commissioning is. So we switch to the live presentation. So I close the presentation. So what are we using? Pepper and Fuchs, and not only Pepper and Fuchs. Another 30 companies. We have a common tool. This is a Pacware tool. So it's not, we are not the owner of Pacware. Krone and Deka, Samsung, they are all using the same interface. I started the user interface. So, and I have installed already a lot of devices there. So on the left hand side, a lot of device suppliers. Maybe you know some of them, Petro, Vensis, Costa or Krone, maybe. This is our company. This is a valve supplier. This is a gateway supplier. This is a and neutral supplier. This that is used here. And some other. And I could add a lot more companies. What I have to do to make the commissioning, I have to add the drivers of the hardware. So the first thing, I have a connection to the switch. The switch has no DTM, it's only a switch. But from the switch it goes to the Ethernet cable. So I add DTM, the driver of the Ethernet cable first. I add device, now I get a selection from the device catalog, so I click to, you can see it's called COM for communication. Gateways, the names of the DTMs are COM. Communication DTM, is COM, communication DTM, and it comes from this web application. I add it. So if you have a network, so if I click now, this is because if I click to the DTM, then the user interface opens. You see, there's a nice picture shows that it's the DTM of this table. Now we can, for example, set the profile address and code whatever profile concerns. So if you have a question at any time, please ask. Yeah? So, okay. Now I have the possibility to search these device. At the moment we have only one in our network. If, for example, 5 or 10 of these devices in the network, then I get a list. At the moment I have only one device, and you see, this is an Ethernet gateway, so each Ethernet participant needs a network. So I click to it, now I can search. So, and the device itself has also a DTM with nice functions, with nice diagnostics for Protobus DP. But I'm not from Prepping Hinstedt, so I would like to show that what I know from our company, so I'm not so familiar with this one. But for example, you can measure some active devices and telegrams. A very nice function is, that I would like to show you, I can make a scan of my network. So now I initiate a scan. Now the device is looking for the Profibus participants connected in this network.
So you've set the Profibus gateway off scanning, not the switch?
This one. So, and we found two devices. Both of these devices. And we found one, the device with address 3. And we found another one with address 4. You see? Yeah. And this, the address 3 is now our segment coupler. It's one participant. And the next one is the Anderson Hauser. It's a pressure hose. So in the next step, we have another two devices. devices on my network. The next step is I have to add the segment coupler from Tetherbox. So I get a list. Select. This is our model number. It's special. This means this is a broken USDP segment coupler. I add it, and now I'm asked for the address. This is why I need to know the address. Because here you are seeing the DTM, the software, and this is the hardware. And there's a little switch where I can configure the address. I have to say to the software what address. Or I choose it. The next step I have to do to measure the monitor physical layer, I have to add the DTM from our diagnostic module. It's called the diagnostic module A for advanced. This is what I have to do. I have to add it one by one. So what I showed you now, the step by step, can be done automatically. But if you have your band, a lot of devices you can initiate, it's called the topology scan. Topology scan, and then hardware searches automatically. But I show it in this case hand by hand, that you can see how it works. So now I'm finished. What I'm doing now is I will connect, make a connection to my diagnostic module here. So now I have a connection. I'm finished. So I told you in my presentation that there are nice commissioning tools that helps you commission so-called wizards. And I'd like to show you a wizard. You can find it here, additional function, it's called conditional wizard. Start it. Now the data will be uploaded from the device into the software. And yesterday, two days ago, we had a workshop in Cork. This is the commissioning from Cork. And two things. The first thing is called the system commissioning. System means commission the hardware here. One time. What we have here, we have a segment coupler, and there is a possibility to connect to external power supplies. So we would like to check if we have the correct working power supplies for field buses. I start commissioning, I click to segment. Now I start commissioning. So, and we get a message. So, primary power supply voltage, you can see here, 24 volts. Here, secondary power supply voltage, 0. Now we have the chance go out of the band, our facility, or phone the guy, hey, have you correctly connected the power supply? Can you please check it? And for demonstration I made a little mistake, of course. So I forgot to connect the secondary power supply. Now when I'm switching to the second coupler, it's not easy. This was my first value, 0. I can reset it to okay. Now I solve this problem. Process. Everything is okay. I see my system now. and what you are seeing here is live. As you do it in live in the brain. How the diagnostic module measures the segment and store the data into the function, the reference value. Today, commissioning reference value. The tools, depending how fast your computer is, something. Work with an older computer, it takes more time. We are live. And when it's finished, we get proposals for alarms. For 24 volts, it's okay. So now the question is, when would you like to have an alarm? And the module itself makes a proposal for us, for example, that we get a low maintenance alarm when the voltage drops below 22 volt, and low output specification means between 90 and 22 volt is okay, but below is without the frequency of the voltage. If we get an alarm, we can change it. But if not, you cannot. Same is, maybe the unit fails here, 1 or 2 or 5 years later, whatever, and then the voltage will increase, whatever. You get an alarm. If you are happy with it, with the values, we confirm it, and now we finish the commissioning of the segment. That's it. The next step we have to do is we have to commission. Sorry, I said segments. We finished commissioning of the system, which means the hardware. Now we are looking what is connected to our system, to our hardware. Are the cables correctly connected? There's a box, cannot look inside. What about the screen? Is the screen correctly connected? And what about the device here? Is it correctly connected? Is the device working perfect? Whatever. And this is what we do now. We make the segment commission. So now we can here we can type in what kind of junction boxes are used, how long the cable is, and so on. For the test, for the demo, I don't need. But I have here a message. The message says at the moment my segment status is, it says out of specification. So something should be wrong. But we do not know at the moment what. So we found here our pressure transmitter from Andrew Mauser, this address 4, you remember. So it is actually working on the segment. Normally you can communicate with a device, but something should be on its limits, yeah, out of specification. It's out of the normal field specification, but it's still going. So we get, if you proceed, we get information. Diagnostic data. So our module reads diagnostic information, and this is the information we receive. And it says the overall quality of the segment is out of specification. Either at least one physically measured segment parameter or its minimum or maximum value exceeds the feedback rate for out of specification. A lot of plants are running out of specification, but the problem is that small thing happens in addition then stops working. Now we get an additional diagnostic information that single levels of one or more field devices are high, and in addition we get information, yeah, the reason would be a trunk break between field bus couplers. Trunk means this is the cable going to a distributor, maybe there is a break. or another also failure could be if you terminate. So if you are working with feed bus, you know each end of a feed bus get the terminator. So we get some hints from out of the DTM what the failure could be. This can repeat. In addition, I can, for example, check my field device signal levels, so it measures the field device signal, and I get an information here on the server bar. You see that the signal is too high. So when the signal is too high, we have too few terminators. So we can again go out and check if everything is correctly. Second mistake I made. This is installation only to show what the problem was. We have here directly on the motherboard of our segment coupler, we have the possibility to switch on and off the terminator. So I switched it off for demonstration purposes. Now I switch it on. And you see, now it's okay. You have a status exit. And we can proceed with condition. Here we have now system status, it did. Segment status is also now okay. No mistakes, no failures. And we can proceed with our segment. The same procedure now, every signal is being measured. It takes some seconds, 1 minute or two, the variation is measured. And then get the same proportion to set alarm limits. So we can confirm what proportion were given by the diagnostic modules. They come from the feedback specification, or we can change them depending on what you would like to do in your system. This is a status bar. It's the same on each DTM that you see. It's connected, for example, a simple thing is connected. So it's the same on each DTM. These buttons, next, backwards, OK. There's a difference. So now we are finished. Status is excellent. Get finished but close. And now the diagnostic, the DTM generates a report. It's a report that can be used as a PDF for the documentation, for your documentation. To confirm that we made a very good condition. Here you can read what was needed. So this is a module, for example. This is the complete measurement of voltages, of currents flowing to the segment. Unbalanced means, for example, if somebody forgot to connect the screen, there is no balance. Not correct balance, it's just an unbalanced. Noise means, if a big motor is running, then it causes ENC. Or a frequency. Frequency converter. I don't know the
spectrum.
Great. DXP causes DXP. Jitter means the quality of the feedback signal. Sometimes there are the field devices on the market who send out bad signals, and these bad signals causing jitter. This complex because jitter is a value that has a high value. And of course, the values of the signal itself for both of us, we have to calculate 850. Okay, then now we are back. this Profibus PR master device means that is inside our segment coupler handling the communication. This is also correct, and here we can see the addresses, the participant of the bus. In this case, we have only the okay. And at the end, we get a nice table showing us the levels coming out from the specification, so that we can see what means, for example, a noise. A good noise means below 50 millivolts, it's okay. But when it increases, for example, to up to 100 millivolts, then this is only for documentation for your phone to see what you want. So now we are finished. Again, we get proportions for alarm units. You can use them, alarm units, for example, for noise. Here, high output precipitation rate increases, it's up to 100 millivolts, then we get an alarm that will be a bad one that we have to. We can confirm them or we can change them. It's up to you. Now we are finished. Now we are finished, we commissioned our field assets. It takes a long time, 20 minutes. So, now we finished our commissioning. Later on, during operation, the measure, all values will be measured over the complete life cycle. At the moment, we have a good signal, but there is a motor that will be starting, for example, then the noise will change and you get an alarm. I do it again, what I did before with the terminator, I switch it on off, yeah. Mm-hmm. I switch it off. You see how the value changes, that now the alarm is out of specification. That you can see in your system, that you can check what happens. Typical problem when the boxes are installed in the field, water increases, for example, corrosion, and then values are changing, and then going, for example, the maintenance required, you don't have to make a message in the operation to check. So this is only one example for a DTM, in this case for the DTM for field bus commissioning and monitoring during the life cycle. So you can see by which interface you see the tape information, and the information that can be sent to your host system. Any questions for the moment? Then I thank you. So another, we have 1 minute time, I will show you 1 minute time. Some additional functionality is possible with this with DTM in general, and especially this DTM has an oscilloscope integrated that can measure for the field bus networks. For example, you can open this can open the function of the oscilloscope. So where can I start it?
Yeah, the oscilloscope.
I cannot see the button. So yeah. I said to the oscilloscope, if the field device start communication, then I will have so down with it. Here, sorry. Now the it starts measuring, for example, the fields. It's a little bit special, yeah. But if you get some problems on your fields and you do not know exactly what happens. For example, in the night for 1 hour it stops, and then you can measure, for example, and find out what happens between 2 and 3 o'clock in the night. And we can see there how it is, which gives you information, for example, the drive started or whatever. It's a specialist. Only to show you one example, what is possible within